Hi everyone. So I'm just going to run through a few different ways that you can create graphs using data exported from SalesData in Excel. We receive a lot of requests from our advisory group and from users like you all the time about how to create graphs and if we can build more graphs into SalesData. So we thought it would be great to kind of show you guys how simple it is to create graphs yourself, so you can create exactly the graphs you need with exactly the data that you want. So I'm using Excel for Mac 2011, but the basic premise is the same in the PC version of Excel and in other years of Excel as well. So feel free to give it a try in whichever version you have. All of the reports that I'm using are exported directly from SalesData. I did change the ISBNs and titles to protect the anonymity of our data providers. So that's the only change I did make outside of the SalesData interface. I did, as you'll see as I open up the reports, change some of the columns that were available in the reports using the Customize Columns button within SalesData. So those changes you can totally make yourself so you can export reports that look just like these. So I'm going to start with a single title over time report. So let's just pop that open in Excel. So you can see here, this is an export of a single ISBN report with the weeks down the side. Units sold on hand and on order were the only columns I exported for this report, again, using the Customize Columns feature. So let me just pull this window down a little bit farther so we can see it a little better. So what you need to do is select the data that you would like present in the report. So I'm going to include the heading row, and then I'm also going to choose columns 1 and 2, so the units sold and the week ending. And I'll pop down this far. And then from this charts option in the top ribbon, all right, so again, I'm just going to pull this wider so we can see all the options that are available. So from this top graph, I'm going to choose a line chart. Line charts are really great for overtime graphs because they show sort of the relation of each time period to each other. So I'm going to choose line. There it is. So you can see this is the units sold down the vertical axis, and then the date periods are across the bottom. It's kind of spread them out in an odd way. There's only 3 marked here, and you can change that by both resizing the graph, so clicking on this side and dragging it farther across, which gives it more space to lay out the labels in a way that makes more sense. And you can relabel them as well. So there's this quick chart layouts option in the top. You can select different layouts to see sort of different methods. It's a good quick way to change the styling of your graph. You can also change the color of the line using these chart styles options at the top. And you can switch the plotting, so the vertical and horizontal axes. As you can see, for some data sets, it doesn't work great. So we're gonna go back to this one, which looks a little bit more like you would want it to. And if I wanted to extend this graph to add another line for the on-hand information, I would just select this data box and drag it over. And now you can see we have both the on-hand and units sold. I've selected this grayscale option, which is a little bit less compelling with the 2 lines. So I'm just going to switch that so we can see something a little better. So you can see now the difference between the units sold and the on-hand number over time. And I could also drag that box over again to get the on order information graphed here as well. So that's a good way to make a quick line graph for a single title over time. So the next graph I'm going to create is one for a multiple ISBN overtime report. This is a multiple ISBN report with the export set to compare over time. So you can see here we have about 14 titles compared by years going from 2010 to 2005. So what you can do here, we'll start with a line graph because, as I said, that's often a good way to graph an overtime number. So I'll select the heading row and then all the rows of data in this report. again, I selected these columns using the Customize Columns option in SalesData itself. You could also export the report with whichever columns you do typically use, and then just delete the columns you're not going to use in your graph. So again, I'm going to jump over to Charts, start with a line graph. All right, so let me just make this a little bit bigger so we can see what's going on over here. So you can see here, they have each title across the bottom axis, the units along the side, and then each line represents a year, which is not ideal for an overtime graph. So this is where that switch plot comes in handy, because now you can see we have the years across the bottom. Granted, they're going from this year to 2005, which is a little strange, but you could change that by changing the order of the columns. But what you have here then is each line represents a title. So you can see sales were quite a bit lower for all of these titles in 2010 compared to 2005. There were a lot more sold of all of these titles. So that's a line graph here. I'm just going to get that out of our way. All right, so now I'm also going to show you a clustered bar graph of the same set of this data. So I'm going to select all of that data again. And then from this column menu, you can choose 2D columns or 3D columns. You can also use cylinders or cones. Let's just use a regular clustered column for now. All right, and again, I'm going to make this a little bit bigger so it's easier to see. So this one's interesting in the way that it clusters all of the years in the bars for each title. So you could compare 2010 is this dark blue bar on the farthest left across to 2005, which is the orange bar. So this is an interesting way to kind of see represented the life of a title compared to the life of another title, etc. If you switch the plot on this, then you'll see each title is one of the colored bars, and then each year is represented across the bottom. So again, it's depending on what kind of comparison you're trying to do. If you're trying to do a comparison year over year or title versus title, can change the way you want to plot this information. So that's two ways to use a multiple ISBN report to get bar and line graphs. So we're going to make a different type of graph now. This is a single ISBN by markets. That's how I've named the report, but the report this actually came from is a multiple ISBN report with the comparison by markets instead of over time, and only one ISBN in the report. In SalesData 2, there was a report called the All Peers Report that did something similar to this, but with a different layout. We're currently working on building that report into SalesData 3, the version that we're on currently. But for now, if you really missed that report and wanted to use a report like that to make a graph, I'm going to show you how to dummy it up right now using the multiple ISBN report export with one ISBN and different markets. So you can see here, we're looking at the sales of book F, and we have the all markets units sold, and then four other markets broken out here. So if we wanted to make a pie graph of this data to show kind of how each one of these markets contributed to the sales of this book, I'm going to take the title column and then all of these columns. Again, we're going to go to this charts ribbon, I'm going to select pie. You could do an exploded pie. I'm going to stick with a regular pie, I think, for this one. And you can see the issue we have here. Let me just make this a little bigger so you guys can see, is that the all markets is representing half of this pie. So you'll want to deselect that to get yourself a more meaningful pie graph. So now you can see market A has made a pretty significant volume of the title sales of this book. And again, the pie graph I find is one where the quick chart layouts is really helpful because you can change it so that each of the pie sections is labeled with the percentage of those sales, or there's other versions with legends, ones where all of the information is inside the pie, etc. So you can play around with that to see kind of which versions you want. You can also change to an exploded pie, which breaks them apart. Depending on how you like to view the information, it can change the style of graph You can do a 3D exploded pie even, which, you know, just makes it look a little different. Yeah, it all depends on what you're looking to do with your graphs. So feel free to play around with the settings. As you can see, it's not too intimidating, so go crazy. So as you can see here, this is a multiple ISBN report by market. So we have multiple titles listed with different market sales included as well. So what we want to do with this, I think I'm going to make a 3D clustered bar. So again, I'm just going to select the heading row title option because I don't really need the ISBNs to be included in the graph. The titles are probably the more useful point on the axis. And then I'll include all of these units sold columns as well. So then again, we're going to the charts ribbon. And then we're going to select bar, which is just a column graph oriented the opposite direction. So I will select a 3D clustered bar for this one. And then I'm just going to make this a little bigger. All right, so we can see here on this vertical axis, we have each of the titles listed on this multiple ISBN by markets graph, and then each of the markets is a different color. So it really depends again, like how the comparison is more meaningful to you, whether you want to see each book grouped together or you want to see the markets grouped together. So the way you would do that again is use the switch plot. So now you can see market D's sales of this title, or these titles in this group, market C in this group, et cetera, et cetera. And again, you can change the layouts. They provide you lots of different options. This one provides a chart of all the data below. That can be quite useful as well because you get the benefits of the report style and also the visual representation. So you can switch the plots those different ways, switch up the layout. It's really simple, this graph making business. So this report is again a multiple ISBN report with multiple ISBNs and the overtime selected. And the overtime for this is first 13 weeks from pub date. So we're looking at a series. So book one, book two, book three, weeks 1 through 13. And then at the end of this report, I'll just scroll over, there is a summary of the first 13 weeks and the first 52 weeks. So for this report, because we're going to run an overtime report, we're just going to use the sales from the first 13 weeks because those summaries will throw off the line graph that we're about to make. So I'm going to select, again, the last column, which is the week 13 units sold. Oh my goodness. And then I will jump across and select the top heading row of the title column. Again, the ISBNs don't serve a great purpose in our graph that we're going to make, so I'm just going to use the titles for this one. So I've selected all the data I want. I'm going to go up to charts, line. Let's do a marked line this time. All right. So as you can see, a lot of the graphs don't work very well on a super small size. So I'm just going to drag this one out a little bit more so we can see. So you can see we've got the units sold up the vertical axis and the weeks going across. And then each title has its own colored line. Pretty simple. You could use a similar graph using the multiple ISBN report over time, that first 13 weeks. Can be really useful for charting comp titles. So you can compare your title to a group of comp titles and see if there's a trend there in the sales over time, etc. Graphing makes that super easy. And as you can see, I just put this graph together in about 30 seconds. So if that kind of visual cue helps you kind of see patterns, this can be super useful for you in your sales projecting. So as I mentioned before, line graphs are often the best choice for an overtime type of graph. So this graph, instead of charting the sales of titles, we are charting a market comparison between two markets and their total units sold over the last 12 months in this report. So I'm going to, again, select the top of the heading row. Woo! scroll all the way across here to the last row and column of our data in June 2009 units sold. And then I will go to the charts panel and I will select a line graph again. Let me just drag this out. And again, so you can see the over time, and you can see market A, market B, the different lines, and their units sold here. Pretty straightforward. So before we finish up, I'm just going to run one more quick line graph showing a publisher market share over time. So you can see we've got years across the top with the market share percentages and all publishers row, and then publishers A through H. So I'm going to select again the whole series of data that my report includes. I'm going to select a line graph. And then you can see this all publishers row is really throwing off our chart here, because this 100 is really condensing all the other lines together, which makes it a not super useful graph. So I'm going to just yank out the all publishers number here by dragging that bar down. So this is a little bit more useful looking, and I'm just going to drag this a bit farther up so we can see. You can see the differences between the lines a little bit more. You can select different ones and kind of see how they're shaping up and do some formatting that way. Excel's a really powerful graphing tool, and we've only scratched the surface here in this kind of 101 webinar. If there's a report that you get from SalesData regularly that you'd like to know how to graph, if there's a certain type of graph you're looking to make for a presentation and you have questions, please feel free to get in touch with us. You can email me at salesdata@booknetcanada.ca, and I would be happy to help you learn how to use the reports coming out of SalesData as effectively as you need. Thanks so much.